What's good, y'all? First, I just want to say thank you for the support. You guys have been gotten a lot of feedback, a lot of good feedback, a lot of suggestions and shit like that. The Playboy Cardi type beat tutorial I did last week turned out to be pretty good. I'm glad it's helping you guys. So I just wanted to say thank you for that. And of course, you know, one thing rolls into another. So I guess because of that, people want me to do another one. More specifically, like Thousand Band Fani or Mexico Dro. Personally, I think most of those guys have the same type of sound, whether they're artists or the producers themselves. It's pretty much the same process. I would say the only difference is I think Mexico Dro beats tend to be a little bit more faster than the others. That's just an opinion, but I don't know basically how to go about separating the two, but I will make one anyways for you guys. So let's get started. That was not a question, by the way. I've kind of already started something. Nothing crazy. Of course, you know how I start. Start with chords. Then chords give you, you know, a good starting point for the rest of your song. So, this is what I have so far. And I don't know how loud this is going to sound. So, just brace yourself. That's all I have right now. I may change the sound later, depending on how everything else meshes together. But for now, it's fine with me. So we'll just have to see. And don't forget, you know, in most of these type beats, for most of those guys, it's usually bells and pads with a nice beat to it. So, where's the purity? It's a really good plugin, man. Don't forget to use your I don't know if I talked about this in the last one. Don't forget to use your, I guess, guidelines, I guess. See how some of these are highlighted and some of these are darker. That doesn't have anything to do with the notes themselves. Basically, when you start putting instruments in, if you have this right here checked, just go to this little arrow, helpers, detect score cell. Basically what it's doing is showing you, you know, notes that will fit well with what you already have. Now obviously this isn't perfect. It's not always perfect, especially if you're doing something like a diminished scale. I don't know why you would use a diminished scale for this type of beat, but just an example of, you know, how it's not perfect. So you can just follow these guidelines and basically lay something down. actually. That was a white lane, and this is like the usually the black ones right here are ones that won't work. I don't know how, I don't know why they made the black ones the wrong ones. It's funny. Can't be right about nothing, can we? All right. I'm just following the little lanes, the scales right here. It's pretty easy. What I'll do is I'll copy. Actually, I don't need this note. Copy this right here. I'll bring it over. But what I'll do is, instead of this note being low, I'll bring it up. Let me see. I took that out because it was too much. Basically, when you're making these patterns, you want to, how do I put this? From a tutorial that I saw, basically, you want to have a call and a response. So you have the first part of the sequence, which is the call, right? It's basically the question. And then you have the second half of the sequence, which is the response or the answer. And I don't mean like, this is the call, this whole thing is a call, and this is the answer. It's like, this would be the call, and this would be the response. And a good way to make it powerful and make sure that it sticks in people's minds is to have repetitiveness. You don't want it to be too repetitive, but that's the point of the call and response. You can split the two so it gives you a good amount. It's not too much and it's not too little. you hear how that melody, you could listen to that maybe a few times and you'll learn it. Like if you're listening to it, like if you upload the beat and somebody listened to it, they'd be able to learn this part easily because it has those factors, the call and response and the repetitiveness. And another good thing to look for is basically how the notes go up and down. You know, those are good too. So those are three good things that you can use when you're making your melodies. Obviously you won't do that for all of them, but they're just good pointers to keep in mind while you're making the beats. So let's listen again. Make sure I'm still recording. Okay. Had to make sure. All right. So like I said, it doesn't sound too far off from any of the other beats tutorials that I made. So, and if you take a listen to those guys, they're almost identical. One thing I wanted to try out, and I don't know if it's gonna work, but I wanted to put an arpeggio in here, just to kind of spread things out some. I don't know if it's gonna work, but we can try. Let's see. Arpeggiator. Okay. I didn't click on it. Really? Wow. Well, if it's highlighted, then you would think it would be on, but whatever. I'm gonna turn it down because you don't want the arpeggiators to be most prominent in the mix. In my opinion, you just want them to fill space. I'll make the melody first and then I'll go through the instruments. Kind of just spreads everything out. I don't think I'm gonna use this sound though. All right, I'm just gonna go through the sound and see which one I like. That one, but it's fucking with my CPU load. I'm just gonna use this one. If shit crashes, I'll pause the video and I'll continue it. Let me see. Let's see what that does. All right, we'll just leave it. All right. Remember what I said at the beginning, that most of these beats are the same. I think Mexico Joe has faster. He uses a faster tempo. Turn these velocities up. Control B, which is a godsend. And there's the claps. He also likes to use fast hi-hats. Now, I haven't messed around with that, so I don't know how it's gonna sound off jump, but we'll just kind of mess with it and see. I know what I'm going for, but we just gotta mess with it and see how it sounds. Yeah, if you listen to Mexico Joe beat, he uses fast hi-hats. It's not like the other video I showed you to use the hi-hats. Not so much, but for Mexico Joe, he tends to use them a lot. I'd have to find the song. And he uses different variations as far as the notes go. Too high. Control B that. And I will, let's see. Something there. This off here. Just kind of change it up a little bit. Some sounds off. It's the clap. Shit. Is it this one? Fixed it. All right, so I will change this to bar mode. Hold the right point, the right mouse pointer, drag all the way over. Control B, so it's perfectly aligned. I know if you don't put this on bar mode, it'll just put it wherever the hell it wants to. So if you're trying to get it perfect, change it to bar mode. Make sure you highlight the entire sequence, and then just hit Control B. And he likes to use this this 808 a lot, actually. I went back and I listened to his beats, and I thought he would use this one more, but he uses this one more. So now we gotta figure out an 808 pattern for this, so. Just bear with me. I don't know if I talked about this in the last tutorial. If I can't hear 808s because they're so low, I'll put them an octave higher. That way I can hear them clearly, and then I'll just drag it down to the same root note. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, just watch what I do. See, instead of playing in the 5 and 4 range, I'm playing in the 6s. Thing I noticed is he'll have his some of his notes on, like, his 808, he'll have it match up to where the snare or the clap's hitting. So like right here and right here, if you listen. Yeah, he'll have it line up on some of his beats. sounds. Am I still recording? Oh, okay. I don't know what that was. Hopefully I'm still recording. So now that I got it, I'm just going to just that mode. I'm gonna highlight. Nope. Control D, highlight everything, and drag this down an octave. So it's gonna go here. I was trying to figure out how to make the notes shorter, not play so long. Hold on, let me see. If I go into here. What he usually does, what I was trying to figure out, is he'll have his notes, so they won't play so long, like almost like he cut the decay short. Where was it? I had to redo it because I messed up the SR. All right. was like the snare variations too much. I got the plug sample in here somewhere. I don't know where it's at. Oh, that's definitely not it. Oh, what the hell that was? What's left? Oh, the chant. Can't forget about the chant. Chance you can get as crazy as you want, but we'll just keep it simple here. Simple to me. Another thing I notice he does is he'll have, see how these chants sound different? He'll use this one to kind of accent the other one. So a few to see if I can find something else. Basically, I'm trying to find one that has a little bit of low end. Kind of the low end of the pad kind of meshes well with the 808, and you want to pay attention to that too when you're making these beats. Yeah, man, that's pretty much it, really. Like I said, it's the same, almost the same process, just probably a different speed. Guess I'll do a little bit of mixing so you guys can see that as well. Go to your mixer control. This track. I guess here. I don't know if you guys saw my other tutorial, but what I'll do is I'll split these, put them in here. One by one. I did another tutorial on this, but I didn't show you guys last time. also, my son's hanging around, so if he comes in and he's being loud like he always is, I'll pause the video and I'll start it again. So. Let's see. Play this. Why can't you just? So, pink noise. Here it is. All right. It's another part of the tutorial. I did something separate on this, but. Probably couldn't hear me because I was using different recording equipment. This is Pink Noise, people. If you're trying to get a good level on your mix, this is the way to do it. Apparently, Pink Noise has an almost perfect, accurate graphical representation of what a mastered CD would look like. So, as far as leveling goes. Okay, it's a flat response, and basically all you're gonna do is loop this part right here, and it's Pink Noise. It sounds just like White Noise, but they're not the same. You're gonna play it over and over again, and as far as your levels, you're gonna bring each one of these up until you can just barely hear it in the headphones or wherever you're mixing. And then once you get to that point, you're gonna bring it down just a tad. And let me see. I want to show you guys. I'll show you guys how it sounds right now, and then I'll show you how, and then make mental note of it, and then listen how it sounds after I use the Pink Noise. This is how it sounds right now. Sorry. That's how it sounds right now. All right, so make a mental note of that. I'll just put another one right there. Okay, so I'm gonna pull all these down. And Pink Noise is loud. You don't wanna turn it down. Leave it exactly how it is. Bear with me. This is gonna be a little bit of a nuisance, a little bit annoying, but this is how I mix most of my beats. So. I think you'll appreciate it, the tip, once you see how it sounds. So just bear with me. For that, why wasn't my other one playing? Oh, it's all right, don't worry about it. All right, so now we can turn this off. Now, remember how it sounded before? Listen to it now. So, solo everything. Where it put the levels right there around six, where the quote unquote optimum headroom level is. So, like I said, it does the trick, and it does it pretty fast too. I use that quite often. That now panning, just use your stereo separation and your pan knobs. Don't forget about those. For the pad, I'll probably bring it wide, because not in there. Alright. There we go for that. You already know what to do at this point. EQ everything. I don't know how my CPU is going to hold up, so I'll try to get all the way through it. If not, I'll just end the video short. Master, but I usually export everything into stems first, 24-bit stems. So that's pretty much the end of this, guys. So remember the important things: call and response, or questioning and answer, repetitiveness without being redundant. Typically faster hi-hats for Mexico Dro. What else? Don't forget the pink noise tip that I gave you guys. And bells. Anytime you hear those bells, you know what type of crazy cartoony anime, you know, beat it is. So just remember those things, and you know, you guys should be golden. And besides that, just keep practicing and listen to their beats, listen to things they do. It's important to, you know, have your own style of doing things. So while you're listening and you're trying to emulate, make sure that you're also creating something unique to yourself too. Like I said, everybody can make Mexico drill beats, everybody can make Playboy Cardi beats, but anybody who knows anything about the business knows if you want a Mexico drill beat, you're gonna probably go to Mexico drill, because you know he makes them the best. So so just keep that in mind when you're watching these videos. Just have a little bit of your own style. But that's it for this one, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope it wasn't too fast for you guys. If it was, just let me know. And please, it took me a while to figure out what I was going to do, because I don't know what you guys want to see, and I just don't want to be throwing shit out there and you guys are like, what the fuck is this? So I like to put in consideration, you know, what you guys want to see. So please let me know what you guys want to see, so I can start building these videos. I'm trying to work on a schedule to start uploading them, but that's not set in stone yet. So that's that. Thank you for watching. If you liked it, just give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment. If you have any questions, put them in the comment section. As usual, you guys know I will respond to you guys to help you guys out. So appreciate it, and peace, guys. Thanks.